Hi, and welcome to SimpleLogin. This is your main dashboard where you can create new aliases, generate a random one, or see all the statistics about your existing aliases, your forwards, replies, and blocks. We automatically generated one alias for you, which is to receive our newsletters. If you want to test out how this works, you can disable it, and you will stop receiving our emails immediately. When you want to re-enable it, just click on this button again, and the alias is enabled again. The main features of SimpleLogin can be found on this exact page, the aliases one. To create a new alias, click on New Custom Alias. You will be given the option to input a name, choose one of our public domains or use one of our custom ones, select a mailbox, and then you can click on Create to generate the alias. Just as the other alias, you can enable it and disable it with one single click. Don't forget to download our Chrome extension so you can also generate aliases, disable existing aliases, and also search for your alias in the Chrome extension. When inside the dashboard, you can also do so many things inside of SimpleLogin. For example, if you want to send an email, this is the place to do so. To send an email, you can click on the button Send Email, input your contact email address, create a reverse alias, and send an email to this reverse alias. By doing so, your contact will receive the email from your alias and not from your real mailbox. We have a full tutorial on this on our YouTube channel and it's linked in the description. Another thing you might want to do is add your own custom domain. To do so, navigate to Domains and input your domain. For example, let's say your domain is domain.com. Click on Create. All you have to do is add this TXT record and these MX records to your DNS zone. Everything else on this page is optional, but we highly suggest you add them as well. This can be found in different places based on your domain provider, but we have a tutorial for Namecheap and it's linked in the description as well. Another thing you might want to do is set up new mailboxes. To add a new mailbox, simply click on Mailboxes and add your new one. For example, let's say I want to use my ProtonMail account. Then click on Create and SimpleLogin will send an email to that email address. Let's look in the inbox. Here you go, this is the email we received. Simply click on Confirm Email, Confirm, and the mailbox is confirmed. Now that it's verified, let's refresh this page and you will see it's enabled. Now, when we go back to mailboxes, you will have a default one, which is the one used when creating aliases from the SimpleLogin extension, and you will have a new one, which is verified as well, and you can create aliases with it. So when navigating to the main dashboard, and creating a new alias, you will see the option to choose the mailbox. You can also choose both inboxes, which means every email sent to this alias will be sent to both email inboxes. This is very useful because when you have multiple mailboxes, you can also choose which one to link to the alias from the More option. So if, for example, in the future you don't have access to this email address anymore, you can simply select the new one or add a new one, and then update, and that's it. These mailboxes will now receive emails sent to this alias. Another interesting feature is the Send Email button, because now emails sent from both of these mailboxes will go through the reverse alias. Another very interesting feature of SimpleLogin is inside mailboxes, because every mailbox can have a PGP key. So when clicking Edit, you can see the pretty good privacy key in here. You can insert your custom one, and you can also decide to hide the email subject when PGP is enabled to add an extra layer of security to all your communications. These are the basics of SimpleLogin. In this video, we analyzed how to create a new custom alias, how to add a mailbox, how to add your domain, and how to add PGP keys to your mailboxes inside of SimpleLogin. As one last step before we go, please note every alias can be transferred. So for example, if you add your custom domain here and create an alias with it, you may want to share it with your organization. To do that, click on More, and then Transfer. When doing that, you can create a share URL, copy this URL, and send it to another SimpleLogin user. As soon as they click on this link, they will be given the option to receive the alias in their dashboard. Let's copy it, and let's paste it in an incognito window. As you can see, I'm prompted to log in. Let's log in into an existing SimpleLogin account. And here we go. We have received the alias we just sent. We can choose the mailboxes. As you can see, we have a lot of them here. Let's say I want it to be connected to these two mailboxes. And let's click confirm. Now the alias is added to the main dashboard in my other SimpleLogin account. Hope this helps. We're here for any question you might have, and you will find additional tutorials on our YouTube channel. See you soon!